Welcome to USSSA Midwest News. I'm Michelle Roberts.
And I'm Chuckie Kempf. We have multiple guests on the show this week. Lauren Chamberlain's here to discuss the ultimate fast pitch experience, the upcoming MPF season, and the USSSA Pride Series in Italy.
Then we will have the Midwest Academy Cup presentation where we'll announce the clubs that top the leaderboard. But first, we start the show off with a ton of post-championship interviews, because who doesn't love those? And championship showdowns from a tournament that definitely deserves its name, the ultimate fast pitch experience.
In 12B, the upper division championship between the St. Joe Vipers and the SEK Snipers ended in a shutout in the St. Joe team's favor. The Vipers win it 6-0, and they were pretty excited after the game about the championship and the plaques. Girls?
Our winning experience was amazing.
And spectacular.
It was hard to come back because I thought we were going to, like, lose it. And once all of our, like, some of our attitudes started to drop, it was kind of the team captain's turn to come in and push them up.
Let's go, Ashton and Taya!
Oh, these are awesome! Oh my gosh.
So,
my sentence.
These plaques are amazing.
Yes, yes.
Everything was amazing, guys.
Best ones I've ever gotten.
It's just, yeah, I like them.
I like them too.
Best ones we've ever gotten.
Actually cool.
Yeah.
I like them because you can see a picture of her hitting.
About her form. I like the form.
Yeah. It was probably like a home run ball.
In the 12B lower championship, the Energizers fell to the NKC Fire as the Fire shut them out 7-0 in the championship game. The Fire had to fight their way to the title game, beating Stars and Spike 7-6 in the semifinal. But in the end, got it done thanks to a hot start.
We came out early in the game and we scored a lot of runs and we just held them down there the entire time. It meant a lot to my team because this was a big tournament and I think it gave us a lot of confidence to win in the future.
In 12C, the Lady Crushers slid past their first two opponents by one run apiece in order to get to the championship, where they would face Sluggers Fast Pitch, who also had a couple close quarter and semifinal games. Sluggers swinging the bats well in this one. Runners on for this single through the right side. That'll score one. Not long after, they would get another base hit, this time up the middle that would score another run, and the 12C championship result flipped the script on the Lady Crushers. They fell to Sluggers Fast Pitch by one run. The champ said they've been working toward this kind of win.
It meant a lot because we've been trying a whole lot. We've been working really hard in practice and this all paid off.
In 14C, the Lady Legends met up with Diamond Club Fast Pitch Tenacity. The Legends, with a 6-0 shutout of the DC team who outscored their first two bracket play opponents, 24-2. On the flip side, the Legends had a first round bye in bracket play and then took down the Smithville Sting 9-3. The Lady Legends broke it down into two simple things for us after the game to explain how they won the title.
Well, we used teamwork and a lot of effort.
At the 16A division at the Ultimate Fast Pitch Experience, the Missouri Stealth and the KC Chaos battling it out. The Stealth just couldn't find an opening at one point. Two good catches in the outfield right here on the run by Chaos defenders, but if at first you don't succeed, runner on third, fly ball to right will be caught, but the ball is deep enough to score the runner from third. The Stealth go on to win 4-2 over the Chaos and had a unique way of describing their feeling after the championship.
It was fun. We played hard. We had the best coach in the tournament, and we did really good.
Describe for me how you feel about winning the Ultimate Fast Pitch Championship.
Lit.
Can you put that in a complete sentence, please?
It was lit. It was a lot of fun, and I'm very happy that we won.
On to the rest of the championships you didn't see in the highlights. In 8 Open, KC Dirt Devils edge Angels 8-7. In 10A, Rockets defeated KC Peppers by 1. In 14B, Show Me Crossfire shut out the Mustangs. In 16B, Nationals took the title. And in 18B, Smithville Sting won the title 7-2. MSB had one baseball tournament, and it was on the turf in Topeka, Kansas. In the 9AA division of the Cap City Showdown, the Bombers were crowned champs. In 12AA Upper Flight, Team Force defeated Mudcats 5-1. Up in 13 Major, Wichita Stars bested BTL Hornets 8-4. And in 14 Major, BTL Hornets Jones won over Lightning by just one run.
One of the most anticipated tournaments of the young summer season happened this weekend. It was the Midwest Academy Cup put on by KC Sports, challenging all academies to put their skills to the test. Let's take a look at some of the action. We begin with the 9 and under AA championship between the DC Generals and Prodigy Baseball. Prodigy trying to get something going offensively.
Check out this nearly perfect bunt on the third base line. Lefty hustles to first, just beats the throw for the bunt single. Later in the frame, the Generals find their way out of the jam with a strikeout. Now they come back in, looking to get the bats going. 5-2 in their favor at this point. They would pick up two runs off balls getting to the backstop. They go on to win the game 12-4. Now remember, the Generals, they were one of our favorite interviews from before. They may have outdone themselves this week. Guys, how's it feel?
I don't know what to say, I'm speechless. I mean, we won the championship. This dude over here, Johnny Cueto, closed us out with an amazing pitch.
Johnny Cueto!
And this dude, Michael, over here had the best catches. Hidden dingers. So, it was just a really good day for us.
And this is our trophy.
Yeah! And I just want to say, Johnny Cueto was awesome, and Salvador Perez was the best.
You know, it's really, really a neat thing. You know, there's so many really good academies out here. We see each other all the time, and it's really, really neat to win the big trophies, even the little trophies. You got bragging rights on everybody. It's been a blessing.
In 11 AA at Tiffany Hills, the Andrew County Kings and the Royals going at it in the championship. One of the very close games from this weekend. The Kings come out victorious by just one run, 8-7. They finish the weekend 3-1 with two single-run wins. Up in age division in 10-double, it's the Wreckers getting out to a quick start against the St. Joe Elite. They take a 4-0 lead on this big swing right here that brings in two runs. They go on to win the championship 14-0. And looking at their recent hitting numbers, that's a high-powered offense. In the 14-AA division, the St. Joe Sidewinders squared off with Columbia Baseball in the championship game, one of the late ones this weekend at 8 o'clock on Sunday. Why not save some of the best baseball for last? Both teams had fairly close semifinal games, and this game comes down to the wire as well. In the end, it's Columbia Baseball edging the Sidewinders 6-5. They've now won 7 straight tournament games and 2 straight tournaments.
Coming up later in the show in our Academy Spotlight segment, we'll feature the top academies from the weekend and present them with their shiny new hardware.
All Sports Media is a brand new company focused on everything sports. This year, we'll be working to cover USSSA events throughout the Midwest. All Sports Media will provide coverage of events, educational podcasts, news, and more. For more information and available sponsorship opportunities, contact Justin Stein at the email on your screen. All Sports Media, where all sports meet.
Welcome back for this week's segment of On Deck. I'm with Lauren Chamberlain. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So tell me a little bit why you're in Kansas City.
I'm here with MSP Productions, and they're having me out for the Ultimate Fast Pitch Experience, featuring myself. And it's an awesome opportunity for teams to come together to play a tournament but benefit a charity of my choice, which in this case is my scholarship fund for the Boys and Girls Club of Norman.
Everybody that donated to that cause, thank you guys so much. It really, really means a lot to me. And I was just on the phone with the Boys and Girls Club of Norman talking to them about the donations that I got, and they were so, so happy. So thank you guys so much for doing that.
So you have a lot of activities while you're here. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, we're doing T-Bones exhibition game. I'm going to do some fun interactive things throughout the game, create that relationship with the T-Bones, and also talk about the tournament that's happening tomorrow. I'm going to visit the teams at the different locations. The three top teams that raised the most money for my scholarship fund, we're going out for laser tag. It's going to be a good time, but overall just interacting with everybody this weekend.
I think it's pretty cool meeting her because she can teach you a lot of things about softball.
And it's really amazing having a professional softball player is giving back and how she is helping other people.
Ultimate Fast Pitch Experience!
So you get to interact with the kids this weekend, but you'll also be back coming up. What's that going to be like for you?
Yeah, I'm excited. June 11th through the 14th, we are playing the Scrapyard Dogs and the Charge. So at that specific park was my favorite last season to play at. The fans were awesome in Kansas City. The field was great. The hospitality was great. So I know the team as a whole is looking forward to coming back.
So you're coming off your first season in the MPF. What are your expectations going into your second season?
First season was a bit of a change for me. It's different. I know everybody can say that fresh out of college going into the MPF. It's tough. It's a tough challenge, but it's something that I feel like I needed personally. I got to step my game up for the second season, but I know I'm ready and I know our team's ready.
And you just got back from Italy. What was that experience like?
Italy was so fun. It was my first time going. We were in Verona, Parma, but we played the Italian national team four times, and then the last couple of days we got to do some sightseeing, some wine tours. It was great. It was amazing, but overall a great trip, and I'm looking forward to going back in the future.
The top professional talent will be back in Kansas City, like Lauren Chamberlain right here, but also the top youth talent. What kind of opportunity do you think that creates for youth athletes?
USA Elite Select World Fast Pitch. I think it's a great opportunity. The girls get to play in their own tournament, but it's also interacting with our tournament as well. It makes them get their level of play up, and they're in front of top colleges. It's a great opportunity for scouting as well.
For you, USSSA Midwest Network.
I'm Lo Chamby.
And I'm Em Robbs. We out.
We're out.
Midwest Sports Productions creates a unique atmosphere that allows youth athletes to grow on and off the field. Themed and benefit tournaments such as the Hawaiian Hip Fest.
We love the Hawaiian Hip Fest!
And the Alex Gordon Classic brings out the best in every player. With 60 years of combined tournament directing experience and 7,500 teams participating last year, MSP is the country's largest youth sports provider. For a weekend of ball like no other, choose MSP. For more information, visit playmsp.com.
Welcome back. It's a very special Academy Spotlight this week. We had the first ever Midwest Academy Cup. So with us today, we have both of our champions from AA, AAA, and Major. We first start with our AAA champion, Jeremy Jones, from Building Champions. We've got the cup right here, but I've got to ask you, the first one ever. You guys are up there against all these other academies, and you're honored in the AAA division. What's that feel like?
Oh, it's a great feeling. We're honored as Academy. Just like to thank you guys on behalf of the organization for running such great tournaments and allowing the kids to have opportunities out there. We're really thankful, and it's just an honored feeling, and we're humbled by it. Thank you.
Well, it's a big weekend for Building Champions. I'm going to sit this down, and I'm going to give you this cup real quick.
Thank you.
So there it is. Quite the trophy right there. Congratulations. Yeah. Thanks for coming in.
Yeah, it feels like we're playing hockey or something.
Play a little Stanley Cup right there. Yeah. All right, thanks a lot. Congratulations.
Thank you, Chuckie. Appreciate that.
Taking a look at the final standings from AAA, Building Champions takes the top spot, followed closely by the Midwest Nationals, and then Gamers 12 Gray comes in third. Here you can see a full list of how each academy fared. Up next, it's Prodigy Baseball, our AA and Major Academy Cup winners. Two trophies for these guys. We'll start with you, Jesse McSpadden, and Michael Younghands. We'll start with Jesse. What's it mean? I mean, this is the first ever Midwest Academy Cup. This is a pretty big tournament. A lot of people excited about it. You guys, not only just one, but two. What's that feel like?
It's pretty exciting. We marked our calendars for this tournament. It's a testament to the hard work our kids have put on in practice, and they execute during the game. So it's pretty exciting.
And Michael, you said they don't even know yet. So when they find out, what do you think their reaction is going to be? Because it's really not a regular win. It's not just one team. I mean, this is the whole group getting it done.
I think they're going to be really excited once they see these shiny trophies in the academy. They're going to be really excited. I'm sure all of them are going to want to take pictures with them. So it'll be fun. It'll be fun to see smiles on those faces.
All right, go ahead. I'll let you take this one. You grab that one. Let's see them. Cool. Congratulations, guys. Thanks for coming in.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
And we wrap things up with a look at our AA and Major standings. Prodigy takes the top spot in both, while in AA, Diamond Club Academy, Natural Baseball Academy, and the Midwest Nationals follow them in order. And in Major, it was Prodigy in first, McInsights in second, and Building Champions in third. We'll be right back with a look ahead to next week.
With more than 20 years of experience putting on high-level events, there's no better choice for your team than KC Sports Tournaments. Get the best experience and exposure this summer by choosing USSSA and playing KC Sports Tournaments all season long. Don't miss out on a chance to compete against the best while getting an outstanding tournament experience. We've got events happening right now and all summer long, including our Memorial Day Dual Super NIT, which will once again be broadcast live on MLB.com. At KC Sports, we pride ourselves on making your tournament experience something you'll never forget. Visit kcsports.org for more information.
Welcome back. 654 teams are traveling to the Kansas City area this weekend for the largest baseball tournament in the country, the MSP Hawaiian Hip Fest. Check back here next week for coverage of all the excitement on and off the diamond.
We'll now leave you with all the best pictures from this past weekend. Get on next week's show. Make sure to tag us at USSSA_Midwest on Twitter. Thanks for joining us for USSSA Midwest Network News. We'll see you next Thursday.